Okay, so back to school season is upon us. And that's actually one major reason why you have even more people out there trying to buy tablets. Now, whether you're a student or not, I want to be able to help you with your tablet purchasing decision in this video. At least that's the hope. Let's go ahead and give it a go. Now, before starting, I want you to note that I will be focusing solely on Samsung Galaxy tablets. And the reason being, simply because they are some of the most popular tablets on the Android platform out there. And not only that, Samsung offers the most robust ecosystem for mobile tech on that platform, meaning your other devices will play pretty well together. Now that we got that out of the way, let's go ahead and start with a very easy one. Now, whether you're a student, just a business owner, just someone who's just looking for the absolute best, or an artist, if you just want the absolute best on the Android platform, just go ahead and get yourself the Galaxy Tab S7 Plus. Now, this right here is the top dog when it comes down to tablets on the Android platform. If there's anything that you're not able to do with this tablet, well, that simply means that no other tablets on the Android platform will be able to do it. So don't even bother doing the research. In fact, let me go ahead and help you out with this one real quick. It has the most premium display you can get out there on a tablet, in that Super AMOLED display, support for high refresh rate at up to 120 hertz. You have HDR 10 plus support, 1752 by 2800 for the resolution, a Snapdragon 865 plus, 6 gigs of RAM with an option to go up to 8 gigs of RAM if you were to increase your base internal storage. The base internal storage, so the base model, by the way, would be 128 gigs. So you have 128 gigs, 6 gigs of RAM. And then you have 256 gigs of base internal storage with 8 gigs of RAM, or 512 with 8 gigs of RAM, and so forth. And of course, that base storage is expandable via micro SD card. You have the most modern S Pen that Samsung ever made connected to this tablet here. You have a pretty good camera, you have a nice battery, you have pretty loud speakers on here, and so much more. So again, without trying to be redundant here, this is the best Android tablet out there. Now, if you still want the best Android tablet out there, but you don't mind getting a display that is non-OLED, let's say if you want to save, you know, a couple hundred bucks, and you don't mind that the display is not an OLED display, then of course go ahead and go with the Galaxy Tab S7, the regular Tab S7, which is its own sibling. It's essentially going to offer you everything that you have on the Galaxy Tab S7 Plus that I just went over here in terms of performance, except on a slightly smaller and different display type. So in short, they do share the same specs. Now I want to jump around here and do something slightly different, right? So I want to talk about the Galaxy Tab S5e. Now, this thing is about a couple years old now, or almost a couple years old, but it is the perfect tablet for those who don't care for the Samsung S Pen and they just want the best screen available on a tablet at an affordable price. And let's say that's because they just want to enjoy entertainment on their tablets. So things like just watching videos on YouTube, or even just watching your movies, enjoying your movies. This is the cheapest OLED display you would get on a tablet out there. Well, one of the cheapest OLED displays you'll get on a tablet out there. You're looking at a 10.5 inches with 1600 by 2560 for the resolution here. Great viewing angles, so a very good tablet for outside. You have 64 gigs of base internal storage, 4 gigs of RAM, of course, expandable, just like I mentioned earlier with the Tab S7 and the S7 Plus. You also have 128 gigs with 6 gigs of RAM. That would be for that next tier. It's coupled with a Snapdragon 670. Quad speaker setup, tuned by AKG, so of course, as you know, the sound is just amazing here. And in other words, it is pretty much a tablet made for entertainment. Great for reading also. I'm not sure if I mentioned that already. It's super light with a very, very premium feel to it, and it's pretty thin also. So again, if you do not care about the Samsung S Pen, this would be a very nice pickup. You know, it's a very relevant tablet. Even, you know, today has a fantastic display, as I mentioned. By the way, I just want to take a very quick break here. If this is your first time visiting the channel, well, welcome, of course. If you are enjoying the content so far, I truly appreciate that. Please do me a huge favor. Hit both the like and the subscribe button there. It's a tremendous boost to this channel here. And again, I very, very much appreciate that. Next year is going to be the Galaxy Tab A7 Lite. Now, Now, this is one that is pretty interesting. It's an interesting one. It's obviously a lighter version of the regular Tab A7, which is already a budget tablet. So as you would imagine, this is not made for productivity, but instead it is made for portability. And also you have the fact that if you were to go for the LTE model, you can actually use that as a tablet slash phone, right? So all you have to do is just stick in a SIM card and you can use that as an actual phone slash tablet. In terms of specs and performance, don't expect too much out of this. You know, the performance is fairly modest, and I'm talking here in terms of day-to-day tasks, right? So if you were to do more than that, you are definitely going to run into some stuttering. It's loaded with a Helio P22. Of course, that's the chip. Helio P22 coupled with 3 gigs of RAM, and the base storage here is 32 gigs. But there is a 64 gigs variant available with 4 gigs of RAM, which is actually pretty nice. It does stand at 8.7 inches, again, a small form factor. The resolution here is 800 by 1340, I believe, and also it does not support an S Pen. Now, I wanna stay in the same lane, also still cover those same people that I say would be interested, you know, in portability in this type of tablet, right? So for those same people looking for a portable tablet, let's say this time around they want performance too. Then in that case, they should be going for the Galaxy Tab Active 3. It's also a small form factor. You're looking at an 8 inches IPS display this time, not TFT like the previous one. It's pushing 1200 by 1920p for the resolution. That's already very nice. 4 gigs of RAM with 64 gigs base storage. You have an Exynos chip here. So it's an Exynos 9810. And this guy here is actually IP68 rated, right? So IP68 dust and water resistant. And this time around, you have a stylus support on here. Now it's not gonna be cheap, but at the same time, it's gonna be a top-notch tablet in this category, you know, with the tablets with the small form factor. Now, I still want to stay in the same lane and talk about this time the 2020 Galaxy Tab A, and that will be the 8.4 inches, which actually has a higher resolution on that TFT display compared to the Galaxy Tab A7 Lite. It also has 3 gigs of RAM with 32 gigs of base internal storage and that same camera as the Galaxy Tab A7 Lite. And a quick note that I'm gonna add here for people considering the regular Galaxy Tab A7 Lite or the current Galaxy Tab A7 Lite, make sure to keep this one in mind, the Tab A 8.4 inches, because not only they are sharing fairly similar specs, but at the same time you get full HD plus on the 8.4 inches. So the resolution here is higher, right? Okay, next here is going to be the Galaxy Tab S6. Although it's a couple of years old, it is still a pretty powerful tablet. Plus you have a 10.5 inches OLED display here, 2560 by 1600 for the resolution, Snapdragon 855, 6 gigs of RAM, 8 gigs of RAM also. So you have that base storage of 128 gigs of internal storage and I believe 6 gigs of RAM with that. And if you go for the 256 gigs, that would get you, that would afford you the 8 gigs of RAM. That is fantastic. And again, of course, that base internal storage is expandable via micro SD card. It has a good camera, battery is pretty decent, also very nice sound, tuned by AKG, and so much more, along with the Samsung S Pen support, which is always a must for a productivity tablet like this one. So again, here, whether you're a student, small business owner, just a regular person, and even an artist looking for something powerful at an affordable price, the Galaxy Tab S6 would be something to do, because it's an older flagship tablet, except it still has some, you know, some specs that are considered today as flagship specs still, right? So you'll be able to get it at a discounted price at this point, because, you know, you already have another iteration of productivity tablets that are made by Samsung as of now. So whether you're going low or high productivity, again, this is a pretty powerful tablet. Performance is still top-notch with that chipset you have in there, even in today's standard. Now we're gonna go ahead and talk about the Galaxy Tab A7 now. Not the A7 Lite, as I mentioned earlier, this is the A7, and this is actually a very good budget tablet. I said good budget tablet, right? So not even decent, it's actually a very good budget tablet, because performance here actually comes pretty close to something like the Galaxy Tab S6 Lite, which is a mid-range, right? So you have a budget in the A7 that performs pretty close to a mid-range tablet. It's a 10.4 inches display with a resolution of 1200 by 2000. It's pushing a Snapdragon 662 coupled with 3 gigs of RAM, of course, 32 gigs of internal storage. That's the base internal storage. And one of the things that I really like about the Galaxy Tab A7 is just the sound that it pushes out. You know, I love the speakers that you have. You have a quad speaker set up there and it gets really loud. Now, they're not tuned by AKG or anything, so they're not like super crisp, but they are really loud. It also has a pretty decent battery. No S Pen support though. So I pretty much recommend this one to those looking for a very good tablet, as I mentioned already. Not just like a budget tablet, but a very good budget tablet. This one is really it. Now, the next tier is, of course, the infamous Galaxy Tab S7 FE. You guys already know how I feel about this. I don't even know why they made this if they don't want to sell it, right? It's priced as if they don't even want to sell it. Anyway, so it's a large screen. It's a 12.4 inch screen, which is a very, very nice thing to have that much screen real estate, right? The resolution on there, I believe, is 1600 by 2560. You have a Snapdragon 750G, assuming you go for the 5G model like I did here. You have 10,090 milliamp power. I'm just going all over the place, right? So I'm just going remembering things and just shooting them out. So 10,090 milliamp power for the battery, which so far I must admit doesn't seem that amazing. But other than that, very good performance on this tablet. I was actually pretty surprised. And despite not being a fan of this, no pun intended there. I'm not a fan of this tablet. Despite not being a fan of the Galaxy Tab S7 FE for the fan edition, I would still recommend it to people who have no choice. And I'm saying this because I've been seeing, you know, a lot of comments on my video on that tablet, on the Tab S7 FE, you know, people, especially in India, saying that they don't have, you know, that many different tablets in that, you know, within that category that they can, so they don't have any alternative, you know, in terms of going for something else with the same specs at a, you know, better price. Apparently the Tab S7 FE there, you know, is priced fairly high, but the problem is the Tab S7 and the Tab S7 Plus, they are not being discounted like it is the case in the US here, and I believe in Europe also. So to those people, I may recommend the S7 FE in some situation. Even then, I still feel like you should go for like a Tab S6 or something. But anyway, so I may recommend, you know, to those people to go for that tablet. Otherwise, just buy any other tablet and you should be fine. But anyway, last but not least is my all-time favorite. Of course, that's the Samsung Galaxy Tab S6 Lite. It's a beautiful tablet standing here at 10.4 inches. So the display is 10.4 inches. You have a resolution of 2000 by 1200 here. It's an Exynos chipset. So that's Exynos 9611. It is, of course, coupled with 4 gigs of RAM, and that base storage is 64 gigs, of course, expandable. You have a pretty good battery, decent camera, fantastic speakers here tuned by AKG. That battery also is fast charge capable. You have a Samsung S Pen support, which is one of the biggest appeals of this tablet here. And most importantly, it is appropriately priced. It has a very good price at $350 for the, you know, normal price. And of course, you can find it discounted to $250. You know, tons of people have bought it as low as 220 at one point, I believe. But, you know, it goes up, it fluctuates up and down. So I still do recommend this tablet, you know, to a lot of people looking for a decent mid-range tablet there, but they don't want to spend, you know, an arm and a leg, right? So they just want something affordable with decent performance that is in that mid-range category. So something that would offer pretty good performance. And of course, we know that this is not built for extremely high productivity, but it does an excellent job with, you know, just low, moderate productivity and even somewhat high productivity. It's a very good tablet. Now, that's all I had for you today. I actually tried to go as fast as possible to try to make the video short. Now, keep in mind, of course, that these are just recommendations, right? So none of this is set in stone. Just because I said, you know, if you're a business owner, you could buy this, not that. No, none of this is set in stone. It's just kind of a guideline for you to go off of that if you are in the market for either one of these mini tablets I just went over. Now, I certainly hope that was informative. Of course, please don't forget to like, comments. I'm going to catch you in the comment section. You know, if you have any questions, make sure to put those in the comment section. I'm going to catch you in that comment section. I'm also going to catch you in the next video. Make sure to subscribe. I'm pretty sure I said that already. Make sure to subscribe. I'm going to catch you in the next video. And up until that next video, of course, as always, stay safe out there.